If you're looking for love, romance, or even a friend with benefits online, you're not alone. There are more than 11 million online daters in the UK, with millions more globally. But have you ever wondered what's really going on behind those glossy pics and witty bios? And how can you make sure that your profile stands out amidst the endless choice? Here's a short guide to making sure those love algorithms are working in your favour, and how data science could help you find your next match. Online dating isn't just about luck or fate. It's a sophisticated dance of data and algorithms. These apps are constantly harvesting our information, our likes, our dislikes, even what's in our pictures. At its worst, online dating can seem frustrating, addictive, expensive, and even detrimental to your mental health. Yet millions of us still put our faith into the hands of these digital cupids. But in reality, they're intricate systems designed to analyze and predict human behavior. An algorithm used in many dating apps, including Hinge, is the Nobel Prize winning Gale Shapley algorithm. Think of it like a big group of swipers. Based on who's liked who, the algorithm wants to find matches where no one can leave their current match to successfully trade up with someone else. It's all about keeping things stable, no one jumping ship. So your algorithm approved match might not be your dream fantasy crush, but they could be a really stable match. So it's worth keeping an open mind, and don't let Mr. or Ms. Right slip away with a hasty swipe. Ever get that feeling where you're sure there's more out there, but it keeps recommending the same types of profiles? That's collaborative filtering at work. It makes assumptions about your preferences based on what others with similar tastes have chosen before you. For example, if someone before you chooses a lion and rejects a tiger, then when you also choose a lion, you might not see a tiger appear in your next choices. So while you think you're seeing everyone, you're really only being shown the matches that the app thinks you'll like based on your previous swipes and what others have chosen before you. As you continue to swipe, the dating pool further narrows. If you're feeling stuck in a mismatched loop, you might have unwittingly been lumped in with a group who have a specific set of tastes that you don't share. Time for a digital makeover. There's no reset button on the algorithm, but you could start a fresh profile and see if that leads you in a new direction. But it's not just who you see, when you swipe matters too. Some dating sites purposefully prioritize profiles that are active and match you with profiles active at the same time as you. Different dating apps have different peak times. Catching people at these peak times can boost your visibility and improve your chances of making a match. Think of it like fishing while the fish are biting. Let's say you do get matched. That's it, right? You found the one. Well, not exactly. This is where the placebo effect comes into play. Studies have shown that when you believe an algorithm has matched you, you tend to rate that person more highly, even if the algorithm didn't actually do much. The mere suggestion that you're a good match can influence your perception and behavior. For instance, dating site OkCupid ran an experiment where they told people who were mathematically bad matches that they were great matches. They found that the simple suggestion of compatibility caused people to like each other more. A lot of people believe that uploading the perfect profile picture will increase their chances of finding the best match. And it will, but not how you might think. Apps like Tinder can take information from your photos and feed that into the algorithm. It recognizes themes like outdoors, pets, being on a beach or at a party, and classifies you with similar profile photos. So think twice about posting that fancy dress photo. It could be the making or breaking of a future match. In an effort to win at online dating, data journalist Amy Webb analysed the performance of hundreds of dating profiles and looked at what made some profiles more successful than others. Amy's analysis showed that shorter, well-written profiles using positive language and avoiding niche references were more approachable and increased engagement. Knowledge is power, especially in the world of online dating. Understanding how these algorithms work can help you understand why you're seeing certain profiles and not others, and help you put things in perspective. Making more informed decisions about your online presence will optimize your chances of finding a compatible partner. Remember, while algorithms can help, meeting someone face to face is probably the only way you'll truly be able to see if you're compatible. Happy dating!